We're tracking the potential for heavy rain as we progress through the remainder of the weekend. Hi there, meteorologist TJ Springer here in the Storm Team Weather Center because of some golf coverage. So we'll have the latest if you join us on WGAL tonight at 11. Make sure you do so. We'll have an update on what to expect through the rest of our weekend. But for now, wanted to give you an update on what we're currently seeing. York. We can see those clouds off in the distance. We are seeing some showers and thunderstorms out that way thanks to a front that has stalled. It did bring a little relief the farther north and west you live. The dew points have dropped some, but still, it is steamy out there for many of us. Super Doppler rate showing those showers and thunderstorms from heavy rain falling out across the Philadelphia metro. Aside from that, it's actually been a pretty bright day mixed with clouds out there. Some sun and clouds have been the theme, really, for our Saturday, along with that heat and humidity. We do have a flash flood warning ongoing that is including Camden and Philadelphia, as well as Delaware and Montgomery County. So if you're out around the Philadelphia metro, expect some really heavy rain and maybe some flooding conditions. Make sure you keep tabs on that if you have plans to travel here through the rest of our evening. Here, though, for the most part, should just see sunshine, but still watching out for a stray shower or thunderstorm along with the warmth and humidity. Temperatures in the low to mid 80s through the overnight. This front starts to lift back to the north as more of a warm front, so that should spark up some isolated showers and thunderstorms. We see the clouds continuing to thicken up with lows in the low to mid 70s. Then tomorrow, it's an impact day. We're expecting scattered showers and thunderstorms. Heavy rain is likely, along with that steamy feel, plenty of moisture in the air leading to those downpours with highs in the upper 70s to middle 80s. So make sure you have a way to receive any warnings like that WGAL news app. Feels like temps in the 90s in Carlisle, Harrisburg. It feels like 95 here in Lancaster. So still feels really rough out there. Make sure you're drinking plenty of water. And it's thanks to the dew points that are still up around 70, not in the 70s, like in Reading and in Coatesville. But look at Lewistown, 57 degrees. Off to the north and west, we've tapped into some of that drier air, but closer to that boundary, off to our south and east, that's where we have that moisture pulling together. Now, we do have a risk tomorrow. We have the potential for strong storms. That slight risk does include a good chunk of the valley. This means that a couple of storms could turn strong to severe and include some gusty wind and some hail. Can't completely rule out a spin-up tornado, maybe close to that warm front as that lifts off to the north and east. But if we have some moisture around early in the day, that could keep the stability. So it's kind of a conditional threat, something we'll be watching closely over the next 24 to 36 hours. Now, we do have this moderate risk for flooding, for heavy rain. That includes pretty much all of the region throughout the valley. Doesn't include some of our far western western communities in Franklin, Mifflin, and Juniata County, but most of the valley is under that risk. That's why we have a flood watch now through Sunday evening, and that is including pretty much all of our counties. So make sure you stay weather aware tomorrow with this higher threat of heavy rain. Downpours, strong to severe storms are on the table, I think really from 11 to 8, and they're going to move in from west to east as this cold front starts to slide eastbound. So the window for most of the day with torrential rain, rainfall rates could exceed 1 to 2 inches an hour, and then gusty wind and hail also going to be a threat. Again, can't completely rule out that spin-up tornado. Here's Spricker. Let's time out the rest of our Saturday. We can see those isolated showers and thunderstorms popping up through the overnight as that warm front starts to lift off to the north and east. And there are the clouds. That should help keep some stability, but watch what happens. Here comes the cold front, and we start to see a line of showers and thunderstorms developing. It starts to work in from the west, continuing to work eastbound through about 8 o'clock, and then it starts to lift away as we head through later on tomorrow night. In terms of the rain, some spots may pick up over 3 inches. That's more isolated, but still, I think a widespread 1 to 2 inches is on the table for the valleys. So that's going to give us some much needed rain and try to chip away the drought, but we of course don't need any of those flooding conditions. Here's the News 8 Storm Team 10 day with that upper low moving in on Monday, so could have some isolated showers and rumbles with highs in the middle 80s. Then some ridging develops. We're back into the 80s to near 90 on Tuesday, 90s Wednesday and Thursday ahead of our next system. And that may bring us some chances for showers and thunderstorms really into this coming weekend. And it looks somewhat unsettled with the weather pattern that we're in. Not wash out the days, but storms possible, isolated in nature from late weekend all the way and early the following week. So we'll have the latest again. Make sure you join us tonight on WGAL News 8 at 11, then join Mary Ellen tomorrow for News 8 Today.